I want a blade glowing purple. That'd be awesome. Awesome. Oh boy. I don't know if we should trust this. What do you guys think? A little trapdoor thingy with loot at the end. I keep falling back down. A bell. Oh, dead end. Nasty little trick. I was on to your shenanigans. Alright, so that was easily solved. Just ends there. So I want to check out the... that. This way? Yes. Can't sneak, unfortunately. Checking for secret doors like that. I keep lifting up. There's another door. Just like the area I was in before with all the locked rooms and the spiders. Just now they're not locked. Yeah, they put them in these little pens. How do these things survive? Not seeing anything here, but I'm be surprised at this. A few more doors. Okay, not over here. Oh. Lich dust, giant scorpion stinger, scarab, and holy water. Well, here's that sound again. I hate that. It's like the doors are trying to open. But they can't, because I've already opened them. But it used to happen before with the locked doors and the other spiders. It kept sounding like the doors were opening, but... they were not. It was just remained locked. I don't know what it's trying to do. All I know is that, as far as I can tell, there's only one way for me to go at this point. And that's to hit that switch and go down. Or up. Oh, that's the little trap there. This way. Levitate is wearing off. Good. Yeah, it goes down. Oh, I see. I thought there was water under there, but it's the sun. Look, every time I walked forward, the door would open. Okay, this is like stone, and there's ground down there. Very swiftly. Okay. Interesting. Okay. bat versus spider? Oh no, just a bat in here. The skeleton has been revealed. Maybe here's the battle. I don't see a spider. With these little pens. One with all spiders and the other section with all bats. No. Head for the other room. I want to see if I can get another skill up with my long blade. Still enemies. Enemies! Alright. This will put some distance. No such luck on the long blade. This is the new stuff. Clicky click. Cool. That rocked. It's like a zoo. A zoo to kill. Greetings! You only live for like an extra 4 seconds because I'm no good at long blade. Yet. Took me a while to get up there. But as we go up, I'll get better and better. What the hell is this? Oh, wow. It's like it's leading up to something here. Like, eventually we're gonna get in the middle and maybe Lysandus is in there. Hope so. I've been looking forward to finally meeting the guy, Mr. Vengeance himself. Vengeance! I can almost hear him saying vengeance with that sound. Oh, it goes down again? It's gotta go down because there's a ceiling. I don't want to rotate on axis. I want to go, yeah. Switch. Never heard a spider purr before this game. Now we go up. Purring spiders. Yeah, I'm not sure I want to hear. Hear that. What is going on? There's like molten lava or something on the other side of this door. Well, it doesn't seem to be hurting you any. He might be in there. I mean, it looks pretty special. It looks like the entryway, only with fire. There's another. I can walk here. Okay. That's the center that I was talking about. Did I save just now? I really want to make sure I did. Because I have a feeling something very bad will happen once I go too far in here. Hopefully I'm wrong. I guess I'm wrong. It's like the Daedric Plane version of the entryway to this dungeon. It's like it's the Oblivion, like not the upside down version, like the upside down. The Oblivion version. Well, that's extremely interesting. But I don't see anything there. I didn't find any secret doors out. Interesting is that these pillars look like they can hold a person. Oh, wait. There's a door here. There's a door in the pillar. I checked everywhere but the pillars. I checked. Yeah. I figured the doors would be on the wall. Which, yeah. Huh. It's not a door. I mean, it looks like it is. Weird. These sides have not been revealed, though. Whoops. It's just, I technically revealed part of the map by going close enough to it. There's really no way to get inside the pillars that I know of, unless there's a switch that you have to press. Or flick, turn, whatever. Alright, so I gotta go all the way back. Oh no, it's right here. It's the next way down. I like the way it's been working out so far. It's been like, I'm fairly certain this is going towards the end. Down here in the door. Could this be it? Could Lysandus lie on the other side? A big lever does? Maybe it opens something upstairs. Maybe it opens that door. Maybe it opens that? I I mean, that's my first thought. Out of anywhere to check. Check that room. I'll go do that. Oh, that is the way back behind me. Nothing else open. I've definitely heard a door open. So, sometimes you can see on the map represented an open door. But I don't see anything else. I think it's in that room. They're behind me, right? Yeah. I still don't like this. What did we unleash by pulling that lever? It is a door! Look at that! I was right. There is a switch. Another switch? Really? The bottom goes down. I don't want to be in steel mode. Hold on a second. What am I on? Besides drugs. 160, 123? We're in either episode 163 or 164. I'm gonna put 163. Oh, there's spiders. Alright. One at a time now. I know I'm so popular. Everyone wants a shot. Is that it? Is that it? Is that Lysandus' tomb? Holy crap. I'm not gonna have to fight this guy, am I? Alright, this is what it is. Oh, and the things... It shows it as being lower. Like it would go down even further. It shows it that it... Never mind. You guys know what I mean? Whoa.
I do not seek to be placated. I seek vengeance upon he who slew me. If you would truly lay my spirit to rest, be the instrument of my vengeance against Lord Woodborne of Wayrest.
I knew it was Woodborne. Okay. I will endeavor to do so. Do we have an update? Lysandus' ghost appeared to me and told me that only the death or humiliation... No, he said death. Not humiliation. He said death, I'm pretty sure. Or humiliation. of his murderer, Lord Woodborne, who would lay his soul to rest. Lord Woodborne is a noble of Wayrest and betrothed to Princess Elisana. He has a castle in the wilderness of Wayrest. Huh. Wow. Well, all in all, other than the hard difficulty getting from one place to another, especially getting to this section, this was an easy dungeon. I mean, the toughest thing were some ghosts and zombies. No liches, no ancient vampires. Pretty chill dungeon. Yeah, like you hear that banging, like he's trying to get out. What if I click it again? No. He does not respond. Instead, a door slams in the distance. So yeah, you'd have to levitate out. Unless there's another switch to pull to make this thing go up. But yeah, hopefully you have the levitate spell or the teleportation recall mark, rather, set. Because, yeah, how else would you get up there, right? But luckily we have it set, so. Done. I didn't find too much more on this for a... Oh, I can't put anything in the wagon. I could enchant my shield, too. I didn't think of that for some reason. Because it's adamantium. I figure ebony. Ebony is the best. Let me just see. I forget. Which one's better? So that's material modifiers, right? So I have ebony. I have I'm forbidden material orcish, which I didn't realize orcish was such a high, you know, kind. Technically, I could have put in mithril, because out of anything, I haven't found much mithril stuff. Now that I've said that, I'll probably find a lot of mithril things. But, yeah, I had dwarven especially for armor for quite a while. Dwarven is... damage modifier. So I'm looking at... I'm looking at weapons. Oh, I'm looking at weapons. Armor. Hold on a second. Armor materials, right. So there is leather. Leather is 3, chain is 6, iron is 7. I've forbidden myself from iron as well, which was fine because we found steel stuff soon enough. Oh, steel and silver is both 9 for armor rating. He's talking about armor. but silver is a little lighter than steel. And then there's Elven, which is 11 armor rating, Dwarven 13, Mithril 15, and Adamantium, both 15. I have a weight modifier times 2, so they're pretty much the same. I didn't know that. I guess with a weapon it counts for more. And Ebony is 17. 19 is Orcish, which I have never found, but I'm forbidden in using it. And 21 is Daedric, which I've also never found. Daedric is heavy, too. Daedric is as heavy as steel. Both 2.5 modifier. Mithril and Adamantium. Just curious. As far as weapons, Wow, that's funny. Mithril and Adamantium are pretty much, they're the same. Not sure why that is. The damage modifier for both is plus 3. The damage modifier displayed, I guess is wrong, plus 6 for both. Two hit modifier for both of them is plus 30. Weight modifier was 1.0. Just different, they look different. Mithril is bluish and Adamantium is dark gray. I mean, I'm glad I didn't forbid myself Daedric, but I don't know if or when I'll ever find Daedric armor. I guess I'm gonna look for Lord Woodborn next. Should I go talk to Elisana about this? Lord Woodborn. He's gonna be Lord Wood Dead in a box. That'll be his wood. Anyway. Well, let's get out of here then. Finished it. It took me 8 episodes. Quill and paper, hello. Lord Woodborn's agent's gonna come after me. I would do some practicing. But I can't get to a safe location. Be gone with you. I guess we're going back to Daggerfall. No one coming? I'm almost disappointed, actually. I thought that was something. So we have a few things to do. We gotta go. Oh, our pauldrons are almost new. Our magical pauldrons. Giving us wisdom and agility. And strength and better AC. This is used. So I might want to go enchant the Wakizashi next. That's the best weapon I found down there. We need to go sell a bunch of things. And I want to enchant that thing, so we gotta see. I don't know if there's anything to fix, because I can't fix magic items. So yeah, I don't think there's any reason to go to the armorer then. Yeah, I have some mithril stuff here. They go well with the black. Blue and black, hey. Yeah, we don't need to go to the smithy unless we want just to sell a few things. We do need to go to the pawn shop. Sell all this crap. You can only sell at pawn shops. It's miscellaneous stuff. And a lot of it. Most of what we found is that. And one mithril katana. Which I might want to hold on to just in case. And what I want to do is... cast shield. What I want to do is go to the bookstore and get some books, because this entire dungeon we've been through... what? Seven episodes? Eight episodes. Not a single book. So, in Skyrim, we picked up books pretty easily. I don't think I bought a single book. I found them all. So, that's not the case here. I'm gonna have to buy some books. Because, I only have like 15 red. So that was a pretty cool cutscene. I enjoyed that. That was pretty awesome. I wasn't expecting anything like that. That was pretty sweet. And it wasn't, full motion video. It was an animation. Still pretty awesome to see. Anyway, stay tuned for next episode. I guess odds and ends in the city of Daggerfall. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.